liver abscess. The liver abscess can be classified according to pyogenic, amoebic, candida, and TB. Pyogenic could be gram-positive, gram-negative, anaerobic, or it could be polymicrobial. Pyogenic liver abscess, bacterial, is most common. Male is to female ratio is 3:1. In Entamoeba, male is to female ratio is 7:1. And 40 to 50 million amoeba infections a year worldwide. Extreme age and endemic areas are more susceptible, especially common in tropics. Risk factors include diabetes mellitus for pyogenic abscess and cancer and liver transplantation. Entamoeba common in endemic areas, pregnancy, steroid, cancer, and alcoholic patients. Pyogenic patients can have peritonitis to liver and portal circulation, direct spread by biliary infection, hematogenous spread, look for bacteremia, and right lobe is most common due to the blood supply and drainage. Entamoeba is by fecal-oral transmission to GI tract to liver via portal circulation, can also spread to other extraintestinal sites like heart, brain, and lungs. Majority of the intra-abdominal abscesses are localized to an organ when visceral abscess occurs. The liver is most commonly involved, and in the best known cases of 450 of intra-abdominal abscess were identified during 12-year period. The visceral abscesses accounted for 25%, and liver abscesses were the most common visceral abscesses. The two major mechanisms for development of liver abscess are local spread of contagious infection within the peritoneal cavity or hematogenous spread of the liver. Of the intra-abdominal processes, the appendicitis with rupture was the most common route of formation of liver abscess in past. However, as noted above, the biliary tract pathology is now the most common cause of liver abscess. Suppurative pylephlebitis, which usually arises from the infection in the female genital tract, but may result from infection elsewhere in the peritoneal cavity, is another frequent source of bacterial seeding of the liver. Hematogenous seeding is not the usual pathway for development of liver abscess, in contrast to the splenic abscesses, which occurs less frequently but most commonly arises from the bacteremic spread. The organisms recovered from the liver abscess are varied and often reflect the origin of the infective process. The mixed facultative anaerobic species are isolated more frequently. Approximately 25% of the cultures of abscesses contain anaerobic in Johns Hopkins series. When the biliary tract is the source of infection for enteric, gram-negative, aerobic bacilli and enterococci are common isolates. In liver abscesses arising from the pelvic and other intraperitoneal sources, the organism found in abscess contents are mixed flora, including the anaerobic and aerobic species like bacterioid fragilis. With hematogenous spread of infection, a single organism is most commonly isolated, Staph aureus or streptococcal species. Many other species of organism are reported from liver abscesses, which reflect the geographic differences in prevalence of certain diseases such as Entamoeba, histolytica infection, as well as the common medical intervention including the chemotherapy for malignancy and stenting of the biliary tract. Hepatosplenic candidiasis usually present in the patient who have received chemotherapy, as neutrophils rebound and the neutropenic episode. 60% of the liver abscesses in patients who underwent the transatrial embolization of the hepatocellular carcinoma in one series caused the predominant by gram-positive organisms. Amoebic liver abscesses are important to consider in the patients who are from or have traveled to the endemic areas within the past 6 months. The clinical course and appearance is indistinguishable from the pyogenic liver abscess. However, the amoebic serology is positive in more than 95% of the cases. Diagnostic aspiration of the suspected amoebic abscess can be required to exclude the pyogenic process, but it is uncommon to find the parasites in the abscess contents. Unlikely for a pyogenic abscess, the drainage of amoebic liver abscess is not necessary. The clinical manifestations include the symptoms and signs can be rather protean in liver abscess. The majority of the patients do not have the symptoms directly referable to the right upper quadrant. Fever is most common symptoms at presentation and occurs in approximately 90% of the patients. Non-specific symptoms include chills, anorexia, weight loss, nausea, vomiting, weakness and malaise. Patients, particularly those with active disease of biliary tract, can have symptoms and signs localized to the right upper quadrant and including the pain guarding, punch tenderness and even rebound tenderness. However, the absence of the right upper quadrant findings on the physical examination does not exclude the liver abscess. Only approximately 50% of the patients with liver abscess have the hepatomegaly and right upper quadrant tenderness or jaundice. Fever of unknown origin, especially in elderly patients, may be presenting complaint. Thus, the diagnostic studies of the right upper quadrant and the abdomen are important in evaluation of the patient with pyrexia of unknown origin. Diseases of the liver and biliary tract are common extraintestinal manifestation of the inflammatory bowel disease. Liver abscess related to Crohn's disease primarily occurs in the individual with the known history of IBD, although they can be of initial manifestation in Crohn's disease. Patients present with fever with or without abdominal pain, jaundice, diarrhea, and hepatomegaly. The mechanism of the abscess formation is unclear in the inflammatory bowel disease. It may be due to direct extension of the intra-abdominal abscesses or possibly due to the portal pyemia with secondary seeding of the liver parenchyma. Successful management requires both drainage of the liver abscess and treatment of underlying Crohn's disease. Symptoms usually fever, right upper quadrant pain, constitutional diarrhea. Signs include hepatomegaly, right upper quadrant tenderness, jaundice, and acute abdomen. Workup may include CBC, which show leukocytosis, LFTs, alkaline phosphatase elevated, AST elevated, total bilirubin is elevated. Blood cultures may show bacteremia or may show Entamoeba, histolytica, and echinococcus antibodies. Or imaging, one has to do ultrasound and CT and MRI. An elevated serum alkaline phosphatase level is a single most reliable laboratory abnormality. Other tests of liver function may be normal, but 50% of the patient exhibit elevated bilirubin and 48% of the patient with elevated level of AST. Other laboratory findings include leukocytosis, normocytic, normochromic anemia, and hypoalbuminemia. Occasionally, a chest radiograph can show a new elevation of the right hemidiaphragm and the right basilar infiltrate or the unilateral pleural. The scanning techniques are usually required to make the diagnosis of liver abscess. Ultrasonography and CT are the diagnostic method of choice. Gallium or indium labeled white blood cell scans and MRI can also be used for diagnosis. Gallium or indium scans direct attention to the liver but will not be a reliable distinguishing investigation between abscess and malignancy. This is a CT scan which shows liver abscess. So the growth could be polymicrobial, gram-negative, and Entamoeba histolytica. Other growth could be Streptococcus miliary, Staph aureus, Streptococcus pyogenes, Candida, Klebsiella, TB, and Burkholderia. Management: if 5 cm single abscess needle aspiration or catheter, more than 5 cm catheter or surgery or ERCP drainage could be attempted. Amoeba drainage is not usually required. Treatment with metronidazole and other management should be offered, with the exception of voice to rupture and antibiotic is not working, and immediate need to exclude the other diagnosis. So there are various antibiotics which can be offered along with culture and sensitivity, and with a variable course between 4 to 6 weeks. And for Entamoeba, we can give metronidazole. So drainage and antibiotic therapy are important dual treatment for liver abscess. If percutaneous drainage is attempted, it is most important way, and it has replaced the open surgical drainage for the treatment. However, there are two modalities directly compared in different patients, and the time required for the fever to resolve and mortality were the same in two groups. Mortality was considered averaging 15% despite management. Several factors assist in predicting the failure of percutaneous drainage, and which include the presence of multiple sizable abscess, viscous abscess associated disease of biliary tract. Direct surgical intervention may be more suitable as less the first modality for the situation. Surgery should also be kept considered when there is appearance to the clinical response to percutaneous drainage in 4 to 7 days. Antibiotic. The choice of empiric antibiotic therapy in liver abscess depends upon the probable original source of infection. When the intra-abdominal source is suspected, there are a number of antibiotic combinations which can be used. The biliary tree is suspected source of combination ampicillin and a regime which covers the gram-negative bacillus commonly found infected bile as enterococcus is recommended. If a colonic or other intra-abdominal sites besides the gallbladder is probable, antibiotics should cover both gram-negative bacilli and anaerobes. Aminoglycosides and second generation and third generation cephalosporins are the agents most widely used to cover the gram-negative bacilli recovered in the intra-abdominal processes. Newer antibiotics such as azitromycin, imipenem, and piperacillin, tazobactam, tigecycline, clavulanate, and quinolones like ciprofloxacin provide excellent coverage in gram-negative bacilli as well, but the cost is higher. The most active and cost-effective antibiotic for anaerobic coverage currently is metronidazole. Other traditional first-line agents include cefoxitin and clindamycin. Gentamicin plus metronidazole is recommended as the initial source of liver abscess with probable intra-abdominal source. The duration of antibiotic therapy for pyogenic liver abscess is usually long. In general, the treatment should be continued until the CT scan shows the complete resolution of the abscess cavity. This often requires weeks or 2 months of therapy. In some cases, complete resolution will not occur and the antibiotics will be stopped when two CT scans separated by several weeks and show no change. When this occurs, the patient should be followed carefully to return of the fever and additional CT scan should be performed several months after the last one. Mortality is around 2 to 12% and often due to comorbidities, not necessarily abscess itself. Pyogenic usually abscess is usually gram-negative or Entamoeba histolytica, broad-spectrum antibiotics at first. We need to ultrasound guided drainage and treatment for 4 to 6 weeks.